So it's been about a month since I've put away any of my comics, which has become a real issue. There's just too many of them here, and I need to sort them before I put them away. I figured, though, this would be a good way to demonstrate a very well-known algorithm in computer science called Quicksort. Now, I'm going to confess that I have a bachelor's of science in computer science, and I did not understand Quicksort when I graduated. It's one of those things that I didn't understand until I did it with my hands, and then it made sense to me. So maybe this will help somebody else. This is the pile of comics that we want to sort. What we're going to have is our working set, our stack, and then this is where we're going to do all the sorting. So from our working set, we pick what's called a pivot. A pivot is any random thing from throughout the working set. We put that in the middle. Anything that's less than the pivot goes over here on your left. Everything that's more than the pivot goes over here on your right. Okay? So let's just do one pass. Anything less than Batman Eternal 45 is going to be put over here on your left. Everything greater than Batman Eternal 45 is going to be put over here on the right. Now, pardon my flubs because with all the variant covers, sometimes it's hard to find the issue number. Here we are after one round. If you're ever going to try this out and you do it with comics, just a word of caution, they get real slippery real quick. So what we have is our pivot, our low set, and our high set. Those terms always get confusing. Anyway, this is the less than, this is the greater than. So we take the less than, we push it onto the stack, we push the pivot onto the stack. I usually turn them sideways so I know which ones are pivots, and this becomes our new working set. First one on the top becomes our new pivot, and that's Spider-Gwen number one. Anything less than that goes on your left. Anything greater than that goes on your right. Same deal. The less than pile gets pushed onto the stack. Pivot gets pushed onto the stack. This becomes our new working set. Spider-Man and the X-Men is our new pivot. So this is an example of what's called a bad pivot. The pivot happens to be the lowest thing in the set, so we have no low side to push, so we just push the pivot and gets work on our working stack. It's been 31, 30. Wonder Woman, can the Avengers. push the low set, push the pivot, new working set. Pivot is X-Men 24, sort in X-Men 25. Nothing to push from the low side. Push the pivot, new working set. Working set is one item. That item is sorted. Pop the pivot right into the sorted pile. Pivot into sorted. New working set. New pivot, Superior Iron Man. Six, five. Push the low. Push the pivot. New working set. Push. Push. We have no working set. Pop the pivot. Pop a working set. Push. New working set. New pivot. Push. Push. No working set. Pop the pivot. Pop a working set. Push. New working set. Working set has one item. That's sorted. Pop the pivot. Pop the pivot. Pop a pivot. Pop a working stack. Spider-Woman number 5, 4, 3, 2, Spider UVW verse. Push. Push. Pop the pivot. Pop working stack. Spider-Verse. Spider-Woman UVW. Push. Working stack. Stack, pop the pivot, pop working stack, number two, number three, push, working stack is one that's sorted, pop the pivot, pop pivot, pop pivot, pop a pivot, pop a working stack. About a third of the way through is Marvel 11. 0M there for a second. Richardson number 3, number 2, NO. No working set. Stack up one. Pivot. Pop pivot. Pop pivot. Pop pivot. Pop working stack. 11. 10. Yeah. 46, 48, 49, 50, 15, and miles. there's probably a faster way to do this in person, but if you're talking about a computer algorithm, that's about as quick as they get. Order n log n, Quicksort.